Hi, my name's Ian Kane and I am the village barber. Over the many years that I've been a traditional barber, I've had many men throughout many ages coming in and asking about shaving. And for years, many of them have felt that they've had sensitive skin. So they've come in for some tuition on how best to shave and indeed the products that's best to use. What I've discovered over the years is that the vast majority of men don't shave properly. They lack good shaving technique. Now, largely that's due to very good marketing by the larger shaving companies. But what I want to show you today is the correct shaving techniques where your face will feel glowing at the end of a shave. Many men come in and they're red, sore, irritable. But Ian, they say, I'm using the best materials that's out there. I'm using the foams, the gels, it says sensitive on it. I'm going to show you why that doesn't work. But more importantly, I'm going to show you what does work to give you a good, close, comfortable shave. Now, before we start the shave, I want to just explain a few bits and pieces about shaving itself. The ideal shave starts long before the initial pass, or taking the razor across our face. Preparation of the beard is vitally important. I can't stress that enough. Preparation of the beard is of ultimate importance. Now, you'll notice the difference when you notice these adverts with the shaving gels or the foams. The advert starts and the man is already foamed up. And then he takes his blade and goes, and before you know it, his chin is as smooth as a baby's bottom. Well, you and I, lads, know that it's not quite that easy, don't we? But you see, really, these companies are doing you a great disservice by starting the advert at that stage, because by omitting to show how they've got to the white stuff on the face, they're missing the most important part of the shave. You see, in times gone by, when the barber would shave, it would be a case of getting his brush, working the soap into a lather. That's the process that softened the beard, hydrated the skin, and got the beard ready for a good shave. By omitting that, you're omitting the most important part of it. If I was to tell you what most men do, and most men take less than 4 minutes to shave, is this you? You're standing at the mirror in the morning, you get your can of foam, spray some on, you do that, and then you get your blade, and away you go. Well, there's two things fundamentally that you've done wrong right away. First and foremost, when you think about it, how long is the shaving foam or gel on for? A matter of seconds. Of what earthly good has it done your skin? Well, I'll tell you, not a lot. Because it's simply not on the skin long enough, that's why. But secondly, and most importantly, most men do that. They pat the hair flat. You don't want the hair flat. Because again, most men will use a twin blade or more system, shaving system. The first blade's not necessarily sharp. So what the first blade does is it pulls the hair and the second blade cuts it. Now, if you have barbed hair, which I almost certainly have in my beard now, every man will get barbed hairs because of the rough and tumble of everyday life. The first blade pulls the hair, it's barbed, barb is into the next follicle, second one cuts it, ingrown hair. There's your first problem. So never ever do that. Always circular motions. I can't stress that enough. Circular motions. You want the hair to stand up, not pat down. So that's the first thing that we do wrong. Secondly, we tend to use products which are chemically based and have alcohol in them. Again, that's not the best way to have a good shave. Two things that I find should never be on your face, and that's soap and alcohol, because it's simply too harsh. It removes any moisture you have in your beard. The best thing that I find to shave with, and certainly that I endorse, is a very good shaving oil, because you want it to soak into your skin. You don't want to be taking the moisture out. You want it to be soaking in, hydrating the beard, and also to prepare the skin for shaving. So there's one or two little things before we start. That's us ready to shave. Now I've gone a little bit into the background. Let's now get on with the shave and see how we can go about that in the best way.